Order! Order! You are an incorrigible delinquent at times. Behave yourself, man!
A new poll from YouGov suggests 47% of voters now disagree with the Brexit decision and 40% still agree, making it the widest margin since 2016. Next week, the EU withdrawal bill returns to the House of Commons, with Theresa May wanting her MPs to overturn amendments made by the Lords. The Prime Minister is expected to be spending the coming days getting Tory rebels to stay on her side so that she isn't defeated over key points. Well, joining me now from Westminster is Danuta Hübner, MEP, Chair of the European Parliament's Constitutional Affairs Committee and a member of the Brexit Steering Group. How do you think Brexit looks for the UK right now?
I think we want UK now, to all the colleagues in UK, to understand that the time is just running and that we have to finalise the whole process by October to have time for your meaningful vote, for all our votes also, or decisions on the EU side. So I think this is the most important thing. And I also think that what we see on the UK side is that Madame Prime Minister is having now a difficult time because the decisions are going to be made, which will probably influence also the position of UK and the vision of where UK wants to land.
I mean, how confident are you that a deal will be reached by this deadline?
We will do on the EU side. I can assure you we are doing everything and we will do everything to have it on time. I think we all know that a no-deal scenario is a no-win for anybody. And also in the European Parliament, where we are going to have the vote at the end of the process to approve or reject the results of the negotiations of withdrawal, transition and the framework of the future, we are getting ready and we will be prepared on time to do it as quickly as possible. This might be maybe more challenging on the UK side, I understand, if you listen to what's going on in the House of Commons, in the House of Lords, and the differences that might emerge. So we are hoping that you will also be on time with your decisions and that you will not delay the whole process. That will be a disaster.
How would you characterise the relationship at the moment between people sitting around the table from your side and those sitting around from the UK?
Well, you know, I think from the very beginning, I guess, we all realised that this will be, especially for UK side, a learning process to really understand what we have built together for more than 45 years, what we have been building is now being dismantled. And I think that so far we could see this learning element in the whole process. I think there is a lot of understanding on today, but I think there is also our expectation is all the time just vis-à-vis towards the British partners. We would like to know what is your plan for the future? What do you really want? What kind of relationship? Because you have those difficult red lines on the one side and then this talking about very deep and comprehensive and good friendly relationship, which probably is not really possible with the red lines. So there is also this expectation on our side that UK will decide as quickly as possible on the future that would facilitate also the finalisation of the current negotiations on the withdrawal, and that would also facilitate the decision on the future framework, which we also have to have by the end of October.
There are red lines, of course, for the EU as well as the UK, aren't there? What do you think would be the best solution, for example, for customs?
Well, you ask me for the best solution. You know, I'm one of those who still believe that the best solution is to see UK staying in the European Union, which we know it's impossible now. So now the best solution also is to have everything on time decided. And then on the customs, I mean, the staying in the customs is probably one of the most important decisions for UK to make now, and one that would solve a lot of problems. So I am very much in favour, but it's not up to us to decide for UK way to stay in the customs union. But you also have to remember that just some sort of customs union will always be linked to the lack of no friction or frictionless border. There will be always controls, and not every version of customs union would solve also the Irish border issue. So just saying customs union is probably not enough to, but to choose the what kind of customs union you would like to have with the European Union. Turkey example is a customs union without agriculture, which could not be the case. I think it's too important for Ireland. So it is a broad issue still to discuss.
And you've already alluded to Theresa May and the pressure that she is facing. Do you think that she is the right person to... Do you think she's strong enough to steer the Brexit ship forward?
Well, she is the Prime Minister of Great Britain, and this is the person that is a partner for the Council and the European Union, and it just all the rest is internal issue of the UK. But I would like to say that we have to have maybe a better balance right now between the technical part of the negotiation also and a political element there. I think there are sometimes it would be useful to have more often the political wrap-up of the negotiation. So yes, I would say we lack, I think, political dimension to those negotiations.
Okay, Danuta Hübner, MEP, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.